Hello everyone, Tom from everystepcalculus.com, everystepphysics.com. A problem on line integral today from my menu, and this is off the internet for one of the Patrick JMT and problem. So he's my favorite. Let's do it. Index 8 to get to my menu. And we're going to press second and the cursor down so we can go screen by screen to get to the L section, which is line integral here. And since they give us RT in the problem, you can see the problem on your screen. We choose RT from the menu. And that was the let's go back and look at that menu again here quick. Notice we have RT, which is the original function, XT plus YT plus ZT, and then we have the magnitude of this, of the derivative of that. But in other words, they do it, here's exactly what it is, XT, YT, ZT, which is the function there, times the magnitude, which is X prime of T squared, Y prime of T squared, and Z prime of T squared. Write this all on your paper, of course. We're going to enter our function. You have to press alpha before you enter anything into these entry lines here. I'm going to press alpha 2 times x times y plus 3 times z. Again, I show you what you've entered. You can change it if you've made a mistake. Looks pretty good. And we're going to enter our lower point from the problem. So we're going to press alpha 0 comma 0 comma 0. I say it's okay. Upper limit or point alpha 2 comma 5 comma 4. Now notice that the farthest point, really we're taking, if it was different from 0, 0, 0 in the beginning point, we would subtract the beginning from the end point here. And then when you integrate this with respect to t, that's where the whole system starts. So then we get xt, which is 2t, 5t, and 4t. And we start putting it together here. Here's the original function, f, xt and yt, zt, and then the magnitude is square root of 45. And then we, in integration, remember you always take the constants and out of the integral before you work the integral. So we factored the inside, took the 4 out and then the square root of 45 out, and this is what's left here for integration. So we're going to integrate that, you know, add 1 to the 2 here to get 3 and then divide by 3. And so then we have this here, which we're going to do over the limit of 1 to 0. Write all this down. This is exactly the way it's done. At t equals 1 then, we substitute 1 for all the t's in the function and in the integral. And so here, I use quotation marks here because of the calculator, but you're going to use parentheses when you put this on your paper, so you look like you know what you're doing. And these calculations are exactly right. We come up with 38 with square root of 5. And then at t equals 0, here's the replacements of t with all the zeros in it, and that of course equals zero. And we take the upper minus the lower, which is 38 square root of 5 minus